Okay, I have the Nikkor 26mm f2.8. Okay, I'm using the Zeiss 30. It's been raining out. I'm just panning. I'm at 1/1000th of a shutter speed, f2.8, 1600 ISO. Why am I at that? It's raining pretty good. I have to keep those down. Those back a little bit. So anyway, there's my Wanda. So this is finishing up on the comparison between the Z30 and the R10. Okay? So it's real dark inside, right? If I go by light, it's okay. But if I reduce the shutter speed, it should get brighter. That's why I have it at 1600. So it's down to 1/60th of a shutter speed. I can bring it down to 1/30th, bring in more light, but that's not what it looks like. I mean, look at my dog. She looks better. And we'll leave it at this in 1/30th. So I'm just walking around in a dark house, all right? I got the windows open. But this is the 26mm focal length, which is like a 40, okay? For a full frame camera. I don't know why they just put a 40 on here for an APS-C. But no, they got to put it at 26. So I'm just walking through the house again. Okay. And it's a bright yellow, but I got it on the different color profile, which I've been using all through this. It's called Pop, all right? But it's a picture profile. So I did a lot of snapshots with this. I have the different folders for the different lenses I use. This should give you a pretty good this should give you a pretty good idea of how good this camera is. Okay, so I'm gonna go in real dark. I'm gonna open up the garage door. Now you get much more light. And I'm going to go back to 1000. That's all I do, is I just do the shutter. So you see? The best way to do it is the aperture. So if I put this at, let's say, 5.6, it should be perfect. So I'll just scroll down. You can see the ditch, it's real wet. It sprinkled a little bit, but it really poured rain now. But it's almost done. I don't know if you can see the bird bath, but you see, pretty good little camera, Z30. Of course, it's winter time, it's not overheating. I'm at 4K 30. The R10 probably would have overheated right now at 4K 30. But I just want to show this out, what it can do. It does very well. So, let's see. Yeah. I can get in here. Okay. So I see my face looks like a sunburn, okay? That's pop. And I'm at 5.6 instead of 2.8. So thank you for watching. I hope these videos and pictures give a good representation of the Nikon Z30. And then you'll see the ones where I do it with the R10. Two little cameras. One's about $600 now. The R10, I think, is a little bit cheaper. But I rank them just about the same. Anyway, thank you for watching. Remember, stay safe. Keep smiling. Until next time, I shall see you then. Goodbye, folks. All right. Level if possible. I can't find my phone. Went to my sister and brother-in-law yesterday. They had spaghetti night. And a wonderful carrot cake. Feeding the animals. I'm going to have a hard time with these cans. There we go. Okay. Food of Champions. Come on. Someone peed. Boy, I'm gonna mop that up. She gets so excited. Let me get another battery. All right, so they're finished. He wants to go outside, so this is what I do. I open up the door, and I say, come here, little girl. And watch this, he's gonna go outside real quickly. See, there he goes. Okay, now watch this. Set the light on. You're greedy. Procedure I do every morning. So I have like on this Keurig, I put 2 full cups. From there, just using 1 pod, stir this up. There you see. So he goes and does his thing outdoors, and he'll come back in, and then he'll finish the food here. probably beg for some more. What I do is I just leave the battery here. And I go and get the battery charger. See, I got the full frame battery charger. I got one here. I got one in the bag with the APS-C cameras for the Nikon. So, do that. See, she's already finished with her, with the battery. Goes in this way. See? Just like that. Then you come over here. I put it down here. And with the battery, when it stops flashing, that means it's charged. That's it. Now, turn this this way. And there you see me. Okay. This is the TT Artisan's 27mm at f2.8. Now, there's a 24mm by Nikon, which is a 1.7, okay? And the way you look at it is you look at the bulb, like Peter Gregg says, and you don't look at the flippy string. Now there's a tally light to the right also. You can look at that, you know it's recording, okay? But what you wanna know is if you're in the picture. So with the 28mm, I'm covering the whole picture. You don't really see anybody behind me, okay? This is a f2.8 lens. This is on the Z30. So it has like function one, function two, in front, tally light, a dial in the front, on and off switch, a record. You know, it's like the Z50, okay? Except it's missing the EVF. That's the only thing. So I've been taking pictures with this camera yesterday and this morning. I'm going to do it the rest of the day. Less video, more pictures. And I went into the picture profile to do pop. So if you scroll down, you know you have your basic monochrome, neutral, portrait, whatever. Okay. Then you'll see like dream, Sunday, gloom, whatever, somber. This is pop. And the colors look fantastic. I like this color combination better than vivid. Okay? So if you want some nice, good-looking colors, just put it on pop. And I'll show you some examples just by going outside. And this is in aperture priority mode, okay? So, let's take a look at the outside. There's Dusty, having a good old time. That's what I'm gonna be dealing with today. But look at the colors, okay? Beautiful morning. I don't need to see that. So see, the yard is pretty well taken care of. What you're seeing is winter grass. This is not the Bermuda that's been growing. So winter grass takes over. And I just cut this about 3 days ago. And look at that, it's growing right back. I got a lot of this other grass that's in here, but it started to mulch, okay? It was so long, and it took me to get retired in order to fix all this. I'm gonna tackle that bad boy, and then I'll mow the grass one more time. And hopefully this should be the last time. Now, you see all these nuts? This is from the live oak tree. So they're just gonna drop nuts. So I'll be cutting off branches here, here, you know, want them up off the roof. You don't want them too low. I mean, I love the shade and stuff, but yeah, you gotta take control. But look at these nuts, huge. And there's this coral around here that loves this tree, and he waits for the cat and for the dog to go to bed, and then he gets them. Oh. Okay, so without looking at the LCD screen, just look at the tele light, okay? And what I usually do is I have that turned off when I'm recording, because that way if you're car vlogging, people see that. And that way you can be a little bit more stealthier. So anyway, thank you for watching. Remember, stay safe, keep smiling. Until next time, I shall see you then. Goodbye, folks. Okay, an update. There's my phone. So I had my relatives that I ate last night call the phone, and I had it underneath charging because I moved the power cable in backward, so it's underneath the table where I rested it. So you do something different, and then your world crashes. So it's fully charged. It's working great. I found it. This dog is happy, but she wants to go for a JOG. So what you do is you go, take her for a JOG, and you bring your camera along, and you take pictures or video. And just remember, the battery's still charging, so you carry a couple extra batteries with you. Put them in your pocket, keep them warm. In the cold, they dissipate real quick. But with the battery charger, when you see it stop charge or blinking, it's fully charged on this one. Some, the light completely disappears, and then it's fully charged also. But you don't really want to keep them in the wall and, you know, just keep charging, because they'll charge, discharge, charge, and then, it'll, you know, that you have to worry about exploding batteries and battery life. And the best thing is to have a dummy battery with you, unless you're out on trips, like I am. So anyway, say bye, Wanda. Bye. She said, "Oh." Bye, folks.